Our movie begins with Becky and her brother Cal. She is in the last months of pregnancy. The both are in the car on a trip, and they eat food from a restaurant on their way, and she feels dizzy. He stops the car next to a church, and Becky opens the door and starts vomiting. Her condition become better, but before they leave, they hear a voice of a child shouting, begs for anyone to help him, and the source of the voice is from a field with very tall grass. They get close to the source of the voice in the grass field, and she calls out the child to make sure that he hears them. The child says that he hears them, but he didn't find the way to return back, and he is confined to the field 3 days ago. And there is a woman who behaves with him in a strange way. Becky feels confused about that, and she warning him from entering the field, but he intended entering the field to save the child. He continues to walk among the tall grass, and going deep into the field. Becky moves and behind him, and she tries to call the police by phone, but there is no signal in the field. And she doesn't know that the field separates her and her brother, and they can't see each other cause of the tall grass. Cal still calls out the kid, but the kid doesn't respond to him. He begins to feel remorse for entering the field, but continue walking. It looks that he forgot his eyeglasses in the car, so he can't see well. Cal says to his sister that there is a secret in the field, because there isn't any explanation for what is happening. And he tells her to return to the car again to be in safe. But to do it, they must find each other's place, so they can move together and no one gets lost. Becky tells him that she has an idea so that they know the distance between them. She says that they must jump at the same moment in order to see each other. And he is afraid of his sister, because of her pregnancy. But unfortunately, there is no other solution. And yes, they manage to see each other and the distance between them. When they jump again, unbelievable something happened. Although they didn't make any move, the distance between them becomes larger than the first jump, and Becky sees her brother very far from where he was for the first time. They were both very surprised and couldn't find an explanation for what happening. They realized that the field moves them from one place to another, if they make movement or not. The night comes and they are still in the field, and they can't reach each other. Their energy starts to decrease due to fatigue from walking and because of Becky's pregnancy. Suddenly, a strange man appears to Becky from the grass. He says that his name is Ross, and the missing child and woman are his wife and their son. He tells her that they should be together in order to survive the crisis they are in. Becky moves with Ross, and they find on the ground personal belongings for other people. And Cal becomes depressed because he can't find Becky. Until the kid appeared and approached him, his name is Tobin, and tells him that he can find the person he is looking for, if he is dead. Because the field doesn't transport dead people from one place to another, the kid tells him that he should go with him to find Becky, because they can find where people are, if they reach a certain rock. He doesn't have any other choices, so he moved with him. At the same time, Ross and Becky move in the middle of the grass. Tobin and Cal reach the rock, which is a huge dark-colored rock, and Tobin touched the rock and feels shivered and gets goosebumps. He asks him if he wants to touch the rock, to make him feel better. Before he touches the rock, he heard Becky screaming. Tobin apologized to him and told him it is too late. He couldn't understand the meaning of it's too late. Tobin tries to stop him, because he can't find Becky in this way. But he moves around the field, searching for Becky. One day, a young man called Travis is looking for Becky, because she and her brother have been missing for days. He had a picture of Becky in his car, seems to that he loves Becky and maybe the father of her baby. He drives his car, and keeps asking people if anyone saw Becky by showing them her picture. But he didn't find anything. On his way, he notices a red car next to a church, and he finds it is the same number as Becky's car. But the car is so dirty, and the food was spoiled, and the worms feed on it. It is very strange because they had only one day in the field, but outside the field were days. Travis enters the church to look for them, but he didn't find anything, so he goes out again and finds her book next to the field of tall grass. He thought they were inside the field, so he also go inside to look for them, but he becomes a prisoner and can't come out. The night comes, and he still hasn't found Becky, so he is worried about that. Tobin finds Travis and tells him that everyone is connected in the field. He knows Travis' name and that he is looking for Becky. Although Travis hasn't said anything to him, he told him that he could make him find Becky. And he asks Travis if he really wants to see her. He moves behind the child, but he finds Becky on the ground, and she is dead. In the daytime, Tobin and his family are outside the field with his dog, and he is wearing the same clothes, but cleaner and his hair is combed. He tells his mother that there is someone who says his name behind the field, and the dog runs and enters the field. Tobin runs behind his dog, so they had to enter the field for their son. And we know that it was Travis who called Tobin because they had met before. It seems that the field not only has the ability to move the place of the people, but also plays with time. Tobin screams and begs for anyone to help him, so Becky and her brother hear him. This is the same as what happened at the beginning of the movie, the entering of Becky and her brother the field to save Tobin, who they don't know his name. But the difference this time is that Travis hears her voice, and calls her out. When they hear him, they wonder how Travis is in the field and arrived here. Tobin continues calling him out and says that something killed his dog. Travis tells them to walk behind the child's voice to meet him. This is because the field doesn't move dead bodies, like Tobin's dog who died. Finally, they meet in the field and Travis is there. Becky asks Travis how he got to the field before their arriving. They didn't find any explanation for what is happening. The time in the field is in a state of turmoil due to the interference of the past in the present, and the future goes back to the past. So the time enters a complex time loop. They go together to know how to exit the field. And while they're moving, Becky's phone rang. The caller is an unknown, saying don't make Cal hurt Travis and keep always together and never make the same mistake again. But they don't understand anything. Ross meets them alone and promises that he will help them to find the way out. It seems that Ross knew how to get out of the field. He takes them to the big rock in the middle of the field and says that who touches the rock will know the way out. And when he wants to touch the rock, Natalie stops him and says they shouldn't trust him. Travis pounces on Ross and throws him to the ground and tells them to run away quickly. Ross could free himself, and he grabs his wife's head until she explodes from the pressure and died. And when they saw what happened to Natalie, they knew that there was something not normal happening with Ross. And they escape as fast as they can, until they reach an abandoned building in which they hid. After they enter the building, they try to think about everything that is happening. But Cal blames Travis for everything, and they fight with each other. They stop fighting after seeing Ross approaching them, and they go up the stairs to the roof. They discover that the church is close to where they are. And when he moves on the surface, he loses his balance, but Cal catches him before falling. But the hate gets to Cal's mind, so he leaves Travis and makes him fall off the roof and get injured. And Ross goes up the ladder to Cal, so he runs away with Becky, who notices that Travis isn't with him, and she suspects her brother that he injured him. She goes to the field alone, telling her brother to stay away from her. When he was walking behind her, Ross caught him and fight with him, and tells him that happened many times and he always comes back to him to be beside his dead body, and then he kills him. Afterward, Travis wakes up after he lost consciousness because of the fall, and he reaches Becky, telling her that he regrets allowing her to go here alone. While they are talking, she's screaming because Ross caught her, and Travis is trying to save her before Ross kills her. Luckily, she finds scissors close to her, so she picked up and put the scissors in his left eye. And she manages to escape, and the sky begins raining heavily. Becky is surrounded by strange people without faces, and their heads are covered by grass. The strange people throw her next to the huge rock, but she feels unconscious because of what happened. When Becky wakes up, she sees the rock, then she picks up her phone to call her number, saying don't make Cal hurt Travis, and keep always together, to not make the same mistake again. She realizes that she is the source of the unknown number that used to call her in the past. Becky discovered that this place is a time loop. Travis reaches Becky, and he noticed that the baby dead. Meanwhile, Tobin appears, and he says that his father was the one who killed the child. Travis is furious and continues to shout, so Ross can hear him. Then he can kill Ross by himself. Suddenly, Ross appears from behind Travis, and the two are fighting each other hard. He finds a broken bone in the mud, so he uses it to kill Travis, and he stabbed Travis in his stomach. But Ross tells him that he was the only one who wanted to get rid of the trouble they were in. Then Travis falls on the ground because of stabbing, and Ross forces Tobin to touch the rock. But before that, Becky stands and stabs the other eye of Ross, and he becomes completely blind. And Travis begins to hit Ross, and he continues to smash his head into the solid rock and strangle him using the grass like a rope until Ross finally died. After that, Travis finds that Becky doesn't breathe, and he wails over the death of his girlfriend, and that he lost everything. Although Tobin tried to stop him, Travis decides to touch the rock, and his body begins to unite with the grass and the whole field. He becomes knowing everything that happens in the field, and how they comes out. He gives Tobin a necklace from Becky, to prevent them from entering the field again. Meanwhile, Tobin travels through time, and finds himself inside the church. When he gets out of it, he sees Becky and Cal coming out of the car and going to the field. He moves quickly and warns them from entering, because they would never come out from it. He shows them the necklace that Travis gave him before, and it is the same necklace that she is wearing. They realize that there is a mysterious something happening inside the field, so they take Tobin and move away from the field. They manage to stop the temporal cycle that occurred in the field, at the expense of staying Travis in the field forever, sacrificing his life so his girlfriend could live. Thanks for watching, take care, and see you in the next video. Man, I've been fearless, I let him feel this. You know, I spit it, no cap when I killed this.